What'd you get from that?
Chill out.
Yeah. So we're going to ask you a series of questions. Do you acknowledge that that's not your nature?
Yes.
Do you acknowledge that you are a powerful thinker and that you have long been making things happen with your thought? That by your sheer will and powerful intent that you stand out in the crowd because you're more focused than almost anybody you know?
Yes.
Will you admit that it's been pretty tense for as long as you can remember?
Yes.
And are you now getting it that that tension, while you've earned it, and it is admirable in a physical environment where the harder you try and the more you sacrifice and the more effort you make, the more you're rewarded from the puny little pile, that there's not steady, continuous bliss and satisfaction and ease and flow and a feeling of worthiness and blessedness in that? You're ready for flipping that switch. You really are. And sometimes you do it. But there is a tension about you that we would just put under the big label of, I can make this happen. And we want to say to you, to all of you, you've already made it happen. Now you want to let it in. But when you say, I can make this happen, then you're still trying to make it happen, which means you're not ready to let it in, which means everything that's queued up for you can't get in because you're still trying to make it happen. And when you're making it happen, you're still considering the contrast. Well, you can launch rockets all day, every day, and there is a certain satisfaction in that. But oh, compared to getting in this flow of divine intervention, divine cooperation, where all that is, who knows everything that you desire and all of the reasons behind it, and where every piece of satisfaction is. Did you notice? Every piece of satisfaction, not every piece of the puzzle that'll move it along, every piece of satisfaction. So our question is, can you accept? We know it feels like we're sort of bullying you into this, but it's because we feel it's so powerful. Can you accept that, Your Honor, Abraham is leading the witness? Can you accept that? The feeling of satisfaction and the accomplishment of the powerful state of being that you want are the same thing. But with emphasis on the pleasure, you can be there now. And with emphasis on the power, you hold it off. Can you feel the difference? When you say, I'm going to tune in and I'm going to take this alignment and then I'm going to accomplish this, you point right at the problem that needs to be overcome. But when you are looking for the pleasure of it, now you've just broken through the atmosphere. Now you're feeling the release of it. And now you're letting the universe have its way with you, which requires trust that you're worthy, and trust that your inner being knows what you want, and trust that the cooperative components have been gathered, and trust that you're going to like it as you move along. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, and as you're using the word trust, I'm realizing that I don't. Mm-hmm.
You know why? Expectation. People let you down. You put your trust in others who don't hold you as their steady object of attention. This is what happens with almost all of you. You trust another human to make you their priority, and it defies the selfish nature that all are born with. Everyone is selfishly inspired because they are attracting to their point of attraction. And so what did we describe as we began today? You and you. Your inner being is you. Your inner being is attracting to you, you see. And so that's why we use words like trust the process, trust the feeling, trust the laws of the universe, trust the law of attraction. And in time, you will trust your worthy nature. You will trust the love that the universe has for you. You will trust the well-being of your life experience. You will trust it. Trust is the only word Esther can find that means what you will understand as we focus upon this. You see, you can look, you can see with your eyes and smell, you can see and hear and smell and taste and touch. And so that's a reality that you acknowledge is real, but what's over here in the vortex, your physical senses can't see it or hear it or smell it or taste it or touch it, yes. And so it requires a trust. Well, what is that? Abraham, you're asking me to now blindly not look and not see and not hear and not smell and not taste and not touch. You're asking me to not use any of the resources that I am comfortable in using and to look somewhere where I can't see it. Just take your word for it that it's over there. And we say, that's why we use the word trust. But in a little while, it won't be a stretch to trust it because you will identify the feeling of love when it's there. The feeling of confidence. You'll come to rely or trust the emotions. So we've been appealing to your logic, and we want to help you combine with you. And as we explain to you the way the laws of the universe work, and then we speak to you about things that you can feel. Like when we were talking about meditation, a lot of you got that. When we're talking about the feeling of release, you get that. When we're talking about moving towards something that feels good rather than away from what you want, which always feels bad. You don't have to trust your emotions. You understand that. You understand the difference between the way loving someone feels and the way hating someone feels. Have you ever, a same person, it's someone you know and you say you love them in your life experience. I love this person, but you're talking smack about them. Do you know what talking smack about them feels like? You're just facing reality, we know. You know what talking smack about them feels like? And you know what a genuine appreciation of them in a moment feels like? Do you know the feeling of goosebumps that sort of comes over you when you get focused upon something in alignment with your inner being? This isn't trust. This is stuff you know. Your guidance system works and you know it. So we're just asking you to trust that when it feels good, it is, and when it doesn't feel good, it isn't. That when it feels good, you're moving in the direction of who you really are and what you want and what you've expanded to, and when it doesn't feel good, you're not. So it doesn't require trust in the sense that you're flying blind. Not at all. Instead, you've got guidance within you that is letting you know, whew, this feels good, you see. Helpful?
Yes.